For example, I grab this JSON placeholder something, some website, as you can see here. If you search JSON placeholder, you should be able to find this. It's basically just some JSON. So if I, for example, click on this posts, it should give us this JSON response. As you can see, it's an array of posts. So I want to basically pull this data and put it in my spreadsheet. And I'm just going to copy this link for now. And I'll go to my spreadsheet, and I need some scripts to do so. So I'm going to go under extensions and do app script. So I'll just quickly just paste that link here as a comment. So we need to pull some data from that. So I'll just store this in a variable. So I'll do const URL equals, and we'll basically just have this link as our URL. So now we should be able to grab data from that URL by using a URL fetch app. And this has this fetch method. And see, what it's going to ask me for is the URL. So I'm just going to type that URL here, like so. And we can go to the beginning here and just basically store this in some sort of constant. Maybe we can just right away call, maybe not. Let's just call it RES for response. And yeah, let's just do that. So we'll take that and pass that URL here. So at this point, we got our response. And that RES is going to have some methods on it, one of which is going to be get content text, like this. So what I'll do, I'll store that in a variable too. So I'll just call it const data, I guess, or data as text. Let's call it like that, because it's really just going to be text at this point. So if I wanted to see what this looks like right now, I could do some console log and basically just get this data as text thing here. So let's just rename this. I'm just going to call it get my JSON data or something. So right now, let's just run this and see what happens. I'm going to just name this project. So if I run this function, get my JSON data right here, so you can see what happens. I'm going to go ahead and hit run. It will probably ask me for some permissions and stuff, which is fine. There it is. So once I run that, see, I get this response right here, which is basically the same thing I used to see here when I went to that JSON page. Now, in this particular JSON response, if you look all the way on top left here, it's a square bracket, which means it's basically an array of things in there instead of just one response. So basically, this is going to give us an array. And in that array, we have this objects in our response. So what that means is that now I can work with this, but you want to remember that at the moment, this is just text. So we need to convert it to an actual JavaScript object so we can work with this. And the way we can do that, we can basically just create another variable here, and we'll do this JSON.parse method. And what this is going to do is going to take that text and it's going to convert it to an actual JavaScript object at this point. So this data now, instead of being just text, is going to be JavaScript object, which we can think about it as like an array of some sort. So just to show you what the data is, I'm just going to add a breakpoint here. I'm going to click in this line 12 so we can look inside of that data so you can see what's going on. All right, so I'm going to save this. And I'm going to click on this debug icon right here. And you can see it's going to basically run this code until it gets to this line where I clicked in this breakpoint, and it's going to stop. And you can see here, now we can explore what we got. And you can see if I look at this data thing, it's an array of 100 things at the moment. And if I open this, it gives me all the rows from that array. So you can see if I go inside of that data zero, it will give me this, where we have basically this user ID, ID, title, and body. And then we have this that gives me the next user ID, ID, title, body, which is basically, if I just go back to this, it's like the first object has user ID, ID, title, body. And then the second object has those same things, user ID, ID, title, body, and so on. So that's what we're dealing with right now, with this particular response, at least. And each one of these, if you look here, it's wrapped in this bracket, so that's basically an object. So what that means right now is that since this is an array, this data right here, because right now I'm looking at this data, see, right here. Because it's a data array, we can actually run all JavaScript array methods, one of which would be the map method, which would be really useful in our case, which will allow us basically, let me just stop this so we can write some code. So I'm going to do map. And this is going to allow me to basically run through that list of stuff, that array here, and do something with it. So this allows us to also save our data, whatever we decide to do with this, to another variable. So I'll just call it results, I guess. Like so. And right here in this map, I'm going to create a variable r, and we'll do this arrow function. Like this. And the way you want to think about this at this moment is that this is going to loop through every line in that data. And every time this R here is going to be this. So it's going to be first time this, then the next time it's going to be this, then the next time it's going to be this. So that's R. Now I can call it something else. Like in this particular case, those was like posts for some website. So instead of calling it R, I could, for example, call it post, which would probably make more sense. I usually like to call this R because R is kind of like a row for me. So at this point, when we look at this post, it's really this. Now within that post, now we can decide what we actually want out of it. So let's say I want the title and I want the body of that post. Or maybe you want ID, title, and body, those three things. That's fine. So what I would do, I would come in here and return an array, which is basically a row. In that row, I'm going to comma separate things that I want to be returned. So from that post, I have, for example, ID. And then from that same post, which is that same object, now I can bunch it, basically return a bunch of things. So I have this ID, for example, I can return this title, I can return that body. So I'll do title, I'll do body, and I think that's enough. So basically, in a single row, I want to get these three things. So what I can do at this point, I can basically just do something with those results. And all I'm going to do right now, I'm just going to return those results. Like so. And save. So once I return those results, now I want to somehow get this information to my spreadsheet, right? So what I'll do, I'll just grab this, save this whole thing, go to my spreadsheet, and basically just do equals and do that. Let's hit enter and see what happens. And you can see how I got that response now in my spreadsheet, which is basically grabbing that data from there and pulling it over here. And this is like an active connection now. So that would be the gist of it, I guess. So mainly the part you want to take away from this is that you basically want to use this URL fetch app with fetch, run this and grab that data from whatever URL you're trying to get this data from. And the rest is really kind of dependent on what your data looks like. So things would change starting from like in here, depending on what you need, you're going to have to deal with it. If you don't want it to be a live connection, you can also do that. So for example, if I didn't want this to be a live connection like this, and I wanted to just basically run this when I wanted to pull that data, then instead of doing this in my spreadsheet, I could just go back to this and just write it to my spreadsheet. So instead of returning this results, which allows me to do that pull directly to my spreadsheet, I'm going to comment this so it doesn't run. So what we can do, we can write it to the spreadsheet. So I can get that spreadsheet. So I'm going to do get active spreadsheet. And I'll just store this in a variable. And then we want to get the actual worksheet we want to write to. So you could get this different ways. So if you want to write it to your active sheet currently, you could do this. Or if you want to write it to a particular worksheet, you can do get sheet by name. And then basically put the name here in quotes, like in this case, it would be sheet one. And then we can write to a range. So we can do something like WS get range. And then we need to set where we want to write this. So I'm going to start from the first row, first column. And then the number of rows. So you can get that number of rows by getting the number of results here. So I'm going to do results.length. And then number of columns, well, it's going to be three columns here. So you could do that, or you can do results, get the first row and get the length out of it. And then finally, we can set our values to be that array, which is that results here. So this way now, if I run this, let me actually remove this breakpoint. Instead of that function that I've used here, we can just have this and we can run this whenever we want. So if I go ahead and run this, I'm going to do more permissions now because it needs my spreadsheet. So hopefully that already ran. So there you go. See, now it's just static data. So you can come back later on and run this again, and it's going to rerun it and get your data again. If there was another object in the body here, over here, you would just do dot after body. And let's say in the body, you have the person who wrote the article, like something. Actually, let's stick with this other notation since we did that. So you would do something like this. And then you could do, let's say in a body, there is something else here. You would do another paste and then whatever that other part is. So let's say there is a URL or something. That's the way you would have done that.